Hello everybody, this is Fernando for the latest Ghosts and Spirits video. Alright, let's go ahead and let's do video number 5 of this go-around with this series here. This will probably be the last one for this particular round, and then I'll give it a brief rest and start focusing on another series thereafter. Thank you so much everyone for the new suggestions. I didn't even have to go into any of the back suggestions from months or years back, because everything this time seemed very fascinating, very interesting to just share right off the bat. So thank you so much again everyone for those amazing suggestions. This go around has to do with a suggestion that is again more than the lines of a subject rather than, let's say, a particular entity, but it does feature one of my favorite things ever, which are various locations where you can find this particular ghost, spirit, entity, whatever it is. And you know how much I definitely love being able to go see and visit exact spots. So those of you that I'm going to name three of them, three locations here in a minute. So those of you that happen to live near these locations, who knows, if you've already been there before, you may have been around these entities. And if not, this will give you a good opportunity to try to find out what they are. And I love to hear what people's comments are afterward too. But yes, it has to do with this. It's the subject matter known as water babies. So let's go ahead and let's talk about all the fascinating info associated with these ghosts or spirits. So what are these water babies? Well, they go by various names, but that is the most common name associated with them. They're also known as Native American water babies, and that's because it has to do more in the lines with the mythology / urban legend status within the Native American culture. It gives you an idea that these ideas, whatever these things are, have been going for a long, long time. And so when that happens, it just becomes part of like an urban legend or some kind of a mythology within their culture. So these particular entities, it's hard still to describe if they're considered ghosts, spirits, some of them even consider them as monsters or ghouls. It all has to do with how these water babies treat others around them, because there's actually variations of of people's encounters with these water babies. All in all, it's probably safe to suggest not to be near these ghosts or spirits or whatever these things are, because it seems like for the most part, they do bad things when it comes to people coming across their locations. But for at least with regards to what they have to consist of, it's this. It's the idea that they could be the remnants of some horrible act, and I'll explain some examples here in a minute, but they're the remnants of these horrible acts that allow them to stay within the areas they're at now, pretty much up until today, up until the present. And so these horrific acts caused them to be created, and then they continue to just haunt, for lack of a better term, that location thereafter. Now, the more innocent ones, as far as these water babies, are those that are considered tricksters, those that just pretty much like to have a good time teasing, maybe even abusing just a little bit, people that come across their areas. But if you do find ones that are more on the lines of murderers / avengers, these are the ones that you do not want to experience, because they are the ones that pretty much had these horrific acts happen to them. And to this day, they still are out there trying to avenge their own deaths. And they're almost considered more in the lines of killing machines. So that's why, again, it's ill-advised to be able to come across these things, whatever they are, if you are within their vicinities. Now, where they're located all has a common unity. They are found near large bodies of water, whether they're considered lakes or they're considered rivers. There's various states out here in the United States that have their location, that are home to these ghosts / entities. It's almost like when I was reading this information, it was almost like La Llorona, how there's always some body of water somewhere within a lot of states out there in the United States that have tales of La Llorona, such as the case here with these water babies. But because these are mainly tied with Native American cultures, it mainly has to do with a lot of the reservations that were associated with Native Americans, both past and in the present too. So I'm going to highlight some specific areas that stood out to me, And again, those of you that happen to live near these areas or have been there in the past, or maybe are even going to them in the future, you'll have a good opportunity of coming across these things. Maybe, of course, doing it on the daytime or doing it somewhere else where you feel more safe. But still, these are the exact locations where these water babies are known to inhabit. There seems to be also no real discernible image of them, even though they're called water babies. It's not like people are seeing actual babies within the bodies of waters themselves. It just seems to be more than lines of ghosts or spirits, whatever you could probably claim as the most generic example of a ghost or spirit. That seems to be what these things are. In a weird twist, some of them are described more than lines of fish-like creatures where they have fins and they have gills, but that's again something else that's just another variation of them. First place I wanted to highlight was this location here, known as Massacre Rocks. Right off the bat, that tells you the mindset or the environment associated with that location. This was one of those areas that had a lot of horrific acts happen there. And the way the story goes is Massacre Rocks is located at Pocatello, Idaho, and this was a reservation area for Indians that were called the Shoshone Indians. And apparently there was a year there where they faced a terrible famine. It was just absolutely horrible when it comes to the dryness of the food, the vegetation, and no doubt of the animals there too. So there was a lot of hunger from that lack of food surrounding them. So they couldn't feed themselves, nor could they feed anyone else being born. So in a horrific act, mothers were actually forced to take their newborn babies, go into that body of water there, the local rivers and lakes surrounding Massacre Rocks, and then they drowned their babies right there. And then that's why these babies, as far as these water babies, roam that Massacre Rocks area, because they are in a sense very bitter, very angry about their deaths. They have never forgotten what their mothers have done to them. And anyone that comes across that location, people can hear apparently their laughter as a way to try to draw them near the water. And when they do so, that's when these things will lash out and then try to drown whoever is there right at that location. So that's one area there as far as Massacre Rocks, again, located by the reservation. This one is known as the Shoshone Bannock Reservation for the Shoshone Indians. And then another area that I wanted to highlight is a place called Utah Lake, which is found in Provo, Utah. This one, though, is a little bit different when it comes to these water babies, whatever they're known there. These actually mimic more than the lines of something to help draw even more people to the area. In this case, it's a child's scream. Anyone that hears, let's say, a child screaming for help or a child screaming in danger, that's a really easy way to try to lure people into that water. But just like with the past examples mentioned, such as the case here with that being a sense of falseness, because all they are is these water babies that are there are trying to bring again the victims straight to the lake, and then that way they can drown them to the bottom too. So no one knows really know about the urban legend, like how these water babies came to be about that location there, like as far as was there some kind of massacre, was there some kind of drowning, something that caused these water babies to exist there, but they are still located by that area there in Utah Lake. So again, if you hear child screams in that location, then you'll know you're near the vicinity of a water baby. So now we've heard as far as child laughter, and then we've also heard children's screams as a way to draw it. Here's another location that I wanted to highlight. This one is Pyramid Lake near Nevada. Near Reno, Nevada. This one interested me because I happen to go to Nevada at least twice a year, and if by any chance there's some, like, let's say, good coincidence that I happen to be near Reno, Nevada, this might be a place that I would love to visit. Set up some kind of camcorder, set up some kind of, I don't know, recorder as far as audio, and then try to see if something could be watched at, as far as, like, let's say my night vision camcorder or something else in terms of the MP3 recorder, see if it captures something on the lines of children's laughter or screams. But yes, as far as this location there, yet again, you have something on the lines of a massacre, something really bad happening, causing these water babies to exist. This one, though, takes a little twist because it's more on the lines of that graphic novel role in movie 300, where the tribe that lived there at the time, the Native Americans, decided that only the strong would survive in their tribe. And the way they did so was any baby that was born that was considered deformed or was considered sickly, they were in turn taken to the lake and then drowned. And that was as a way to try to make sure that, again, only the fittest and strongest would survive in their tribe. Well, whoever was killed within that lake as one of these babies, they have in turn overtaken the lake. And every single year, they specifically target people to try to bring them to their water area and then lure them. And then once again, take them to the bottom of the lake, drown them, essentially. So if you go by that area, Pyramid Lake, Nevada, near Reno, Nevada, and again, you start hearing that kind of stuff as far as children's laughter, children's screams, then you'll have a good chance of being in the vicinity of these water babies, all again being done as an act of revenge when it comes to what happened to them. But there are multiple other areas apparently out there too. There's another one apparently in California that exists. And then I'm pretty sure there's others out there in the world too, especially when it comes to the Western United States. So if anyone has any more info, anything else might have missed as far as other locations or someone being nearby those areas, please let me know. Maybe some other people that grew up in those locations knows more about the mythology or the urban legend status associated with these water babies. I would love for yourself to comment on it below and then share that information with everyone. But what does everybody think? Water babies, as far as these Native American legends, are these true? Has anyone experienced anything like this as far as hearing their laughters, hearing their screams within these bodies of waters in these areas? Anyone visit them as far as these locations in the past, or maybe know someone that did or grew up near around them? Please let me know. It'd be really, really good to hear. I do believe that these things do happen, that they have occurred, like as far as of these massacres leading to these locations, especially in the Native American reservation side, because I know someone that grew up in some kind of area there, and she was telling me some of these tales that she encountered during that time from her childhood. So as far as, like, let's say this stuff happening, I do believe it. Like, there are these things, whatever there are, whether they're ghosts, whether they're spirits or something else, that inhibit these locations. And who knows, maybe I'll have her be able to tell her stories one of these days on my channel. And that'd be a really nice treat for everyone to hear too, as far as the entities and others that roam these locations. But if anyone has any more specific examples that I might have missed, or anyone have any of their own experiences regarding these water babies, please let me know. All right, everyone. Thanks again, as always. Take care. Bye.